Good morning, students. Today we will be studying history lesson for the advent of urbanization and civilization. First, civilization. Civilization is the period of human life when the human society reached an advanced stage of social development and organization. A civilized society is one in which has a developed form of government, culture, industry, and common social norms exist, like the kind of society that we are living in today. By the time people had begun to live in cities and had found the time to develop different interests like music, religion, and painting, the early civilization developed during the Bronze Age. They developed around the river valleys. Basic needs like water and food were easily available near the rivers. Also, the land near rivers was very fertile and fit for agriculture. Minerals like copper were found near rivers. Rivers were also used for transportation, which leading to trade. The Indus Valley Civilization. The Indus Valley Civilization was home to one of the world's largest civilization. It began nearly 5,000 years ago in an area near modern-day Pakistan and North India on the banks of River Indus. It belonged to the Chalcolithic or the Bronze Age. Artifacts made of copper and stone have been found in various sites belonging to the civilization. The civilization was named after a place called Harappa in Pakistan. It was the first Indus Valley site to be excavated in the 1920s. There were many towns and cities in the Indus Valley civilization. The two largest of them were Harappa and Mohenjo-Daro. It is said that Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa had a population of over 80,000 people. The Indus Valley civilization extended across present-day Balochistan, Sindh, Punjab, Haryana, and Rajasthan. The most important sites that were excavated were Harappa and Mohenjo-Daro in present-day Pakistan, Kalibangan in Rajasthan, Ropar in Punjab, Lothal in Gujarat, Banavali and Rakhigari in Haryana, and Dholavira in Kutch. This is the picture of Harappan civilization, and this is the civilization of Mohenjo-Daro, a developed Indus Valley civilization, a city of Mohenjo-Daro. Now, cities of the Indus Valley civilization. Harappa, this archaeological site at Punjab in Pakistan, consists of the ruins of a fortified city. Means it was a well-fortified city which was now only the ruins are left. Mohenjo-Daro, built around 2500 BC. Mohenjo-Daro literally means Mound of the Dead. It means the Mound of the Dead. The archaeological site is situated in the Sindh province of Pakistan and has been declared World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1980. Next is Kalibangan. Kalibangan, the town has been developed at the confluence of the Drishavati and Saraswati rivers in Rajasthan. The unique fire altar found in Kalibangan are one its most significant features. Lothal. Lothal was the most prominent trading center of the Indus Valley civilization. It is located in Gujarat. Valuable gems, beads, and valuable ornaments were traded with West Asia and Asia via the Arabic Sea from Lothal. The sources. The main sources for studying the history of the Indus Valley civilization are the terracotta seals, which were mostly square in shape. These seals have animals and humans engraved on them. The script is yet to be deciphered and will unveil much more than what we know today. The skilled engineers of the Indus Valley civilization. The planned towns. Engineers of the ancient civilization were very skilled and their towns were well planned. They were divided into two parts. The upper part, described as the citadel, was built on a raised platform that was high. All important buildings like the great bath, the granaries, and the town halls were found here. The second part was the lower town, which includes the residential building or houses, all laid out in a grid. Storehouses, elaborate storehouses have been found in Mohenjo-Daro, Harappa, and Lothal. All the surplus grain was stored in these storehouses, which were situated near the river banks, had more than six of them. The Great Bath. Another prominent structure of the Indus Valley civilization found at Mohenjo-Daro was a very big tank, which archaeologists call the Great Bath. It was like a large swimming pool. It was watertight and layers with bricks and mortars. There were changing rooms alongside the sites. The great bath may have been used for ritual bathing purposes. Town halls, houses, streets and drainage. Now the town hall. This is evidence of a structure which may have been an assembly hall or a town hall. Houses and streets. The houses were of two stories and built on both sides of the street. The number of rooms that they had, they were from 2 to 20, and each house had a central courtyard and a bathing area. Houses were separated by a network of roads cutting each other at right angles, forming a grid-like pattern. The main street pointed in a north to south direction, while the secondary street went from east to west. Drainage system. The drainage system was very impressive. They were watertight, which prevented the leakage of dirty water. Wooden screens filtered with water, as a result, clogging and overflowing of dirty water was avoided. The house drains were connected to the main drains. Now, life and occupation of the people. Farming was an important occupation of the Harappa civilization. The people grew rice, wheat, barley, pulses, peas, sesame, that is til, we call in Hindi, alsi or linseed, and mustard. Plogs and sickle used a different method of irrigation were adopted. Fishing was another occupation they were engaged in. Scribes were the people who wrote on seals. Many people were engaged in many different types of craft. Pottery making was an important occupation. Most of the pots were redware and were used as storage pots and burial containers. Evidence show that the people also knew how to spin cotton. Archaeologists have found spindle, which was used to spin thread. There were special workshops where people used to make bronze sculptures and artifacts. Copper and bronze were also used to make weapons and tools. Now trade. Evidence of seals, weight and measures suggests that active trade relations were carried on. Mesopotamian seals were found in Harappa. The dockyard in Lothal suggests brisk trade. The cities were connected with rural agricultural communities through a strong trade system. Trade is reflected in the widespread distribution of beads, ornaments, pots, metals, tools and seals. While the people were self-sufficient, they were more important, which had to be brought in from distant places. Archaeologists think that copper may have been brought from Rajasthan and tin from Afghanistan. This suggests that trade had been carried out between these places. Then seals. Most of the seals have a knob at the back through which runs a hole. It is believed that the seals were used by merchants for stamping purposes. Most seals have a pictorial inscription on them. Some important seals excavated are Pashupati seal, the unicorn seal and the bull seal. These seals were mostly used for trading purposes. Archaeologists believe that these seals were used for stamping purpose. Once packets or bags were closed, traders would dip the seal on wet clay and press it on the closing. This way, people could see that when the seals were intact, it means that the bag has not been opened. And at the last of the chapter, we come to the decline of the Indus Valley Civilization. The Indus Valley Civilization is said to have come to a sudden end due to the combination of several factors. Means nobody knows the exact factor why it came to an end, but there are a combination of different things. Natural calamities such as floods and earthquakes were believed to destroy the area, leading to the migration of people to different regions. It is climatic changes led to drought conditions, perhaps the river changed the course or dried up, thus affecting the agriculture of the place. Conditions of cities like Lothal and Dholavira might have deteriorated and hence impact trade and led to the decline of the civilization.